Welcome to another lock that was sent to me in the name of Don's Locks for his collection. And I know that there is a combination lock inside without the code. So today is combination lock decoding day. And that's a pretty nice one, an old German combination lock with a very long shackle and four wheels with just 8 positions. So I can't even zoom out anymore, so I don't think that I get everything in the shot, but okay. I pull on a shackle, which is pretty hard because I have to do that kind of like stretching my hand here. Okay, I pull on the shackle and I turn the wheels and see which wheel binds first, and that's then the wheel that I'm working on. So let's see, this is loose, this is also loose, it's loose, so one is binding and I felt a little give on the shackle, and it's not bad here. Now I move on to the next one, it's also tight, and the third one, you heard a click and the shackle came out a little bit further. And now I'm on the last one. Ah, it has false gates, looks like. Okay, they're all now locked in place. So this lock has false gates, pretty cool. By the way, I had one of this kind already in my video collection and I decoded that with a shorter shackle. If you wanna look up that video as well, then feel free to do so. So let's continue with that one. False gates. So all are locked in a gate, true or false, and so we have to find out which one needs to be changed. So this is tight, this is loose, this is loose, this is loose. These aren't binding that much, but I think we have to change the first one. And it's not as tight anymore as before, oops. I messed up the rest here. Okay, it's back in business. I think every second. Oh, the second is binding a lot now. So the first one can be moved back and forth. The second, maybe not so much. This is a bit tough to turn the wheels and not to mess up the other wheels. I don't think that the 7 is good. The 1, maybe the 1. So let's move on to the third wheel. I'm trying to find a position of the wheel where it is able to move it back and forth, like so. I'm not confident that this is the right choice here for those wheels. I think the second isn't right. It's tight. Turn it by 2. I think now it's better. Maybe the first one needs changing. Four is very tight. Taking way too long for such an old lock. And maybe I'm a bit rusty. So zero is also very tight. I like 2. These are very loose, but I think these are loose because they aren't binding right now. So the 5. 5 is also a bit loose, so I change again here. Maybe I test the 5. How about the 6? I think the 5 is now tighter. Whoa. I totally ruined everything. Let's see that we can get back in business, and that's really hard to tension the lock here. Okay, we have all in a gate again. 6. Okay, the second wheel isn't right, so I turn it by 2 numbers. And it's also tight again. Tight back here. That's a bit better. Now the third is tight. Maybe the third is... I think they're all... Okay, I give it a chance with the last one, but I don't think that we succeed. There, it's so loose. Okay, the first one is really tight. I have to change that. It's tight again. It's a bit better. So let's keep 2 in mind, but 4 isn't good. 6 isn't good. 0. 0 is so la-la. No idea. All feels the same. This lock is not bad at all. Okay, maybe we change strategy. Let's see if we can feel an impact on another wheel. So first, the first is a bind, and now 1 is loose. Move it back to 6, and 1 is tight. Okay, I think we should stay with 1. Okay, 0 can, so the third can be moved back and forth. Change it to 3. Oh, it's even looser. Not a loser, but it's looser. That's tight. At 1 it's tight. And okay, let's see the last combination. So that's the indirect method. Seeing what impact it has. And now the last one is pretty tight. So it's, and it's open. Oops, don't mess it up. Okay. So the combination is, where is the error? The combination is 5630. It has taken quite some time, and the direct method didn't work, where you change the wheel's position back and forth to see if the gate is wide or narrow. Narrow is a false gate and wide is a true gate. The difference between the two states of true and the false gate were, the difference wasn't that obvious for me, so I changed my method to the indirect method, where I looked at a change of resistance of the following wheel when working on the wheel before, so to say, and that was pretty effective. And now here we have it. The code is 5630 and the lock is open. All right. Yeah, Don's Locks, thanks a lot for this very interesting lock, at least that I could have decoded it for a video. It goes into your into your container with all the locks that were sent to me by now. And yeah, everybody else, thanks a lot for watching. Happy picking and bye-bye.